Today, we are going to draw a pine tree. We're going to start off with drawing a horizon line. Normally, you wouldn't want a tree right here on the horizon line. You'd want it down around in here, so it came up over the horizon line. Now, I'm going to move it over just a little bit to the right or the left. It doesn't matter because I don't want it right in the middle. Even though this is not a finished drawing and it will never be a finished drawing, I'm not comfortable having things too symmetrical. So we're going to start here with a trunk. Pine tree trunk is not very thick usually, unless they're really, really old. Okay, so we're going to take out that line right there. We're going to give our pine tree, and you can use this in any kind of a tree. Bark has lots of different variations. So we are going to just put in very loose. I'm not trying to do anything exotic or exciting. At this point, however, I need to decide where my light's coming from. And as usual, I put it over here. This is just my go-to spot. Yes. Okay, so if the light's coming from here, this side of the tree is going to be darker. So we're going to put that in. I'm going to go right up to the top. Now, when I start painting a pine tree, I start in the middle. I don't start at the bottom. I don't start at the top. And here's the reasoning. I start in the middle. I can adjust the bottom and the top to look sort of symmetrical or have a decent shape. If I start at the bottom and work my way up, possibly I'll have it too fat way up into here, and then it's almost too late to fix it. So I start in the middle, and I'm not gonna put in specific branches. I am doing what is known as scumbling. And I'm just letting my pencil go. How wide do I want this tree? And do I want the branches to turn down or go up? And that's totally up to you. I may put these in a little wider here towards the trunk of the tree. Now, I don't want one right opposite that. I want it lower. Okay, so now I have a base. I know where I'm heading. So again, I don't want one right opposite this. It can be partially, but mostly it has to be below it. And you have to remember that pine trees are they could be conical shaped, like a cone, but there's going to be several branches that always go out of their way to be the star. Now, as we come down, they need to get wider this way and wider this way. I don't know if you notice, I turned my pencil right then to get a sharper point. So we're just going to keep doing this. And now I'm going to put one more here. He's also going to not stick out as far, just because I don't want him to be so perfect. Now we're going to head on up. And you can see it's starting to go in. So we're going to go up another one. Once you've got your shape going pretty well shaped, I could go and finish all of this. I could come back down and finish all of this. I'm just going to go up here another couple, and then we're going to play around with it some more. The branches themselves are getting more narrow. We're going to go around. We're going to start right about here. We're going to go around, come out over here, and come out over there. So we've got something going around behind that. Now let's finish it up down this way. These need to be much wider in both directions. I've got an overhand hold on my pencil. I'm going to take them pretty close to the bottom This might be the last branch I'm gonna do. I don't know, we'll see. Okay, so we have a decent shape. I think I'm gonna go one more. I'm making my pencil go in different directions. There we go. Okay, we've got a decent shape. We've got some pretty big holes in between there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna come back in here and we're gonna put some that look like they're going to the back. And to do that, we're gonna make them smaller, shorter. And we're just gonna fill in some of these big gaping holes. This one here is gonna come like it's coming forward, and you're not gonna see a ton of it coming forward. It's foreshortened. So pick out some places where it looks kind of bare, like right in here. He's gonna go up more to make it look like it's in the back. They're shorter and they're going in a different angle because you're looking at them from a different angle. Okay, so I think I'm getting happier. And I know you want me happy. Okay, so it looks fuller. We can put something else in here. Something else in here. You can also have, like, here's a pretty big bare space. We could put actually two in there. Because I don't want those two to look alike either. Here's another big bare space. Let's get something going to the back of that one. So they go up at an angle more and they're shorter. Here's another bare space. Okay, so now it looks much more full. You don't notice that these are shorter and different angles and all. It just looks fuller, okay? So I'm gonna come back in here with this and get this side of the trunk darker because we've got those branches coming in there. There we go. That looks pretty good. Okay, now, so our light is coming from here. So we need a shadow this way. Now, it would be more advantageous for us to have a, if the light were coming here, we could have a bigger shadow. But we've already made the light come from here because of where we have highlighted the trunk and things. So let's get this here, and we're gonna come in here like this. Now we could do something along these lines for a shadow, although I'm not sure I'm crazy about that, but it's a possible, it's a doable. And you can come back in with your eraser and take out what you don't like. If this drawing class is helping you in any way at this point, I sure wish you would hop on over to the playlist for the entire drawing series. I'll put it, I never know where to point, you know? It'll be up here somewhere. The playlist has the entire beginning drawing series on it, and it will be extremely beneficial for you, your homeschool kids, your kids for the summer, whatever, to learn to draw. Let's get back to the drawing. This almost looks like a branch because it's not long enough. So we're gonna bring this tree and put it down in the grass. Now look how much, just that one line seats this tree. And usually pine trees don't have big roots coming all the way around. We're gonna put a few little ones in here. So that looks pretty good. Now we're gonna, if this tree were out here by itself, we would have, there'd be some grasses growing up around it, okay? So we're just gonna throw in some. And I'm gonna put some back in here against the tree itself. I'm gonna throw some in here. And maybe a few little ones in here and over here. That seats the tree to where you know it's sitting in the earth. It's not floating on a page someplace. You want your grasses going in different directions. They need to cross each other. If they were just all one direction, it would not look very realistic. So we're gonna throw a few little pods on the ends of these, some of these grasses. just barely touching, making a little squiggle. That's all that is. Okay, so here we have a pretty good pine tree that you can practice on. And you can see I've got my hand all dark. Right in here, I have take out some of the smudges. Now, one thing you can do to avoid that is to cover part of it. So if I were working, you know, I could put it here and wherever my hand is going to lay, I could put it, go and do that. And then I might have to, you know, move this around just to keep me, from, as a left-hander, from covering, going over my drawing and smudging it. This doesn't matter because it's never going to be anything that I'm going to mat or frame, but this is a great practice. Why is it such a good practice? Because you're learning to create depth by having this trunk would not be as wide up here as it is down here. It would not be as light on this side as it is on this side. These branches are going, we are trying to add some depth by adding these branches back here to look like they're going back. We are making them wider here, and as they come out, they get more to a point. There's a lot of things that we're learning here. See, you don't even notice this shadow here, but it tells the eye that there's something here. Okay, so I'm going to erase just a little bit of that. Okay, so I hope you have learned a lot from this drawing.
Hey, this drawing video has been brought to you by the Beginners Painting Club, part of PaintingWithAcrylics101.com. My website, PaintingWithAcrylics101.com, is loaded up with all kinds of beginning art classes. Some are free, some are paid. There's a free blog that has gazillions of classes and posts all about drawing and learning to paint. So hop on over to PaintingWithAcrylics101.com, see the full playlist for the drawing course, and so much more. While you're there, there's a free beginning painting class. It's all free. You just have to sign up for it. It'll come to you in your email. And it's all about painting daisies. So it's one of the things that I am noted for. And so it's a free class just for beginning painters on learning how to paint daisies. So let's get going. Let's paint and draw together real soon.